maneno ya 2027. Tafadhali, tupunguze mambo ya 2027.
Will President William Ruto hold on to the presidential seat come the 2027 general election? Well, if social media buzz is anything to go by, many Kenyans seem to think that his chances are slim, especially given the rise in public discontent with some of his policies.
Ninawaambia 2027 Ruto akipita na anajua ni tamu yake ya mwisho atatuchinja sisi wote. Ninawaambia ukweli. Na wale wa Kenya wenye wanasikia wasikie. Kama wanajua kila mtu achukue kura hiyo siku. Na vijana kuanzia miaka 35 kwenda chini, adui yetu ni mtu mmoja tu. Adui yetu ni njaa, umaskini, wamesema hatuendi shule, wameongeza fee. Sasa na Ruto, adui wa nne ni Ruto. Tafadhali, tuchukue kura tutoe hao watu. Plus Raila Odinga, tumini najua Raila ataanguke EU. Hiyo nani?
But if you are part of the crowd thinking he won't be back in office come 2027, I hate to break it to you. You might be in for a surprise.
He's going to pull another Kennedy Matiba on him. This guy is wote watasimama na watagawana kura. Tuseme Morara asimame, apewe 1 million votes zake. Kalonzo apewe 2 million. Wetangula asimame, apewe 500. Musalia anaweza kosa kusimama, anakaa kukwama na Ruto. Wasimamishe Gashagwa apewe 2 million ama 2.5, zitabaki kura ngapi? Around 5 million, 4 million. Ruto achukue 4 million, si amechukua hiyo kitu?
Here's why President William Ruto could very well retain his position in the upcoming elections despite all the noise.
And above all those things, it does not mean well for this country,
mm-hmm.
and we should not have him as president,
mm-hmm.
we should not be comfortable with having him as president,
mm-hmm.
and we should not wait till 2027. Because tell me what miracle will oust Ruto from power in 2027 while he has the state machinery and the system behind him. I mean, if he was able to clinch power in courts in 2022 when the system and state machinery was with someone else, how do you now think he's going to relinquish that power when he has the state machinery and the system with him? And I'm saying this because I understand, apart from is the monopoly of violence that he will have in 2027, he will also have the monopoly of propaganda. Because the government has so many resources, both human resources and physical resources, to decampaign anyone and to campaign for itself. The government can fill all newspapers with ghost projects it purports to have done. The government can even launch a toilet and post it on newspaper. The government can push its agenda through every TV station and every newspaper in this country. It has the fans, it has the people, it has the editors, it has the writers. So you tell me how Ruto is going to leave power in 2027 if we allow him to stay in power till 2027. My opinion is we should have this guy out of power before 2027, whether by resignation or by whatever means, but we should not have him in power. By the way, I am very frustrated that we have a parliament in this country that has been state captured by the president we have, because we already know he has captured parliament, and the parliament we have does his bidding. I am very frustrated that this parliament did not see it fit to impeach the president, even when they knew he has, one, violated the constitution, even when they knew he has stolen so much from this country, even when they knew his purported projects were ghost projects, even when they knew that his bitter development, whatever, was hogwash, and even when he killed us when we hit the streets. To this day, parliament is not comfortable with impeaching Ruto. And they are not going to impeach him now that ODM has been conscripted into government. Hata mimi nimeona maajabu that an opposition party would be comfortable with getting into government for the fifth time in this country. How is Raila always comfortable with getting into government through the back door? Kama Raila ange support Gen Z's, saa hii hata tungekuwa tuna call for another election. Si Raila ndio watu wangekuwa wanasema tunapigia kura. I mean, mean, watu wangesema this mzee has been consistent na hata amesupport these young people in liberating this country. With all his deficiencies and weaknesses, Kenyans would have gone for Raila Odinga. But then he decided to get into government through the back door. Na angepigiwa kura hii 2024 vibaya sana. Watu wakua na machungu na asira mingi sana za William Ruto.
So ningetaka tu kuuliza, according to you, if things don't change, come 2027, President William Ruto will still retain the seat.
Brother, mimi nimeona watu wengi na vipindi. That's why I don't follow akina Morara, akina Kasmuel. You would never see me with them. I have never appeared in their videos, but they have appeared in my videos, in the demonstrations, sana sana Kasmuel. But I have never followed them. Because I understand how selfish everyone is. And I understand tumebeba ufala for too long by worshipping some people. Mm. Watu wameworship Raila for too long na amekuwa akiwabeba ufala. Now people want to worship Kasmuel and Morara na watakuja kurealize tunabeba ufala when it's too late. Let me give you an example of Sakaja. There was no politician in this country who appeared as sober-minded as Sakaja was before the 2022 elections. Sahi Sakaja anaweza sema kitu umsikize. He has been conscripted into a puppet by this government. He does the bidding of William Ruto and Raila Odinga. They run the county government of Nairobi, not Sakaja. I mean, he does not have the moral authority to lecture them because he's also stealing from the county government. See how exorbitant fees he's paying to law firms in this county for representing the county government of Nairobi. That is one way of stealing our funds. If we start doing an audit of the funds we've lost in the county government, in the past 2 years, Sakaja has been at the helm of government. Utashangaa sana. We've lost so much money. Hata Bobo Wino has done that audit, informed by what the Auditor General had posted about the county government of Nairobi. Mm. So if someone is objective as Sakaja, who sounded all wise and all moral, could turn into a hyena who feeds now on us, then how easy do you think it would be for watu kama akina Kasbwell and Morara, who have not even tested power, to easily be conscripted into the bandwagon of thievery in this country? They probably would turn out to be as bad as akina Sakaja. But people can't see that. People are easily falling into their trap. And I'm not taking away their legitimacy and saying that they probably will be as bad as the current leaders we have. But before we follow people like gods, before we follow people mindlessly, do we care to question the consistency of some of these fellows? Kasmuel said he is going to quit revolution and whatever we have as a movement if it is found out that effect is abduction. And we all know effect is abduction to gain some political mileage. And we've proved that, but he did not quit. Morara was crying the other day before he now became popular, saying he is going to quit activism because it appears the Kenyans he was fighting for. I'm saying fighting in quotes because he ought any content creation and upuzi. The Kenyans he was fighting for do not wake up and stand with him.
So, we just want to know, at the end of the day, if things don't change, will President Ruto still maintain the seat in 2027?
Oh, I digressed. I was saying that because Kasmuel pretends he wants to be president. Morara also wants to be president. Kalonzo wants to be president. Raila will want to be president. I am assuring you that. Ruto will want to be president. And every other person in this country will want to be president. So, with the division of votes, Ruto is already dividing Mount Kenya, as you've seen. He is funding Kithure Kindiki and Central Kenya MPs. Now you see Ruto has some wit behind him. Political wit, I would say. Yeah, anajua kupanga mambo yake. Na unaona ashaanza kupanga Mount Kenya. He is going to divide Mount Kenya into two. Mount Kenya East and Mount Kenya West. One side will go to Gashagwa, the other side will go to Kithure Kindiki or someone else. He has the funds to fund Ndindi Nyoro and Kimani Ichung'wah and promise them a DP position. He will promise them to kick out Gashagwa and take them up as his deputy presidents. So you see, that way he will have won Mount Kenya. Because he divides them, that means hata wakisimamisha Gashagwa as president, hata pita, because we still have tribal politics in this country. So if he has dealt with Mount Kenya, he has dealt with his area of Rift Valley, because Rift Valley bado watapea Ruto kura. We still are a tribal country. Sasa amebakisha to deal with Western and the Luo people. Nyanza na Western inafollow Raila. Ameweka Raila mfuko. If Raila gets the UC seat, let me assure you, probably, hata tukipiga kelele aje, Ruto will still be president. He has bagged the Luo votes and the Western votes, and he is going to divide Mount Kenya. So itabaki ni akina Morara, akina Kasmuel, Kalonzo, na Jeremia Kioni akitaka kusimama, waitishe kura, wagawane hizo kura zenye zitabaki, na hakuna mtu atapita. And that is what happened in 1997. Moi funded akina Matiba, waitishe kura. I mean, it wasn't Matiba. Who was this? He funded two candidates in Mount Kenya, waharibiane kura. Yes, it was Matiba. Moi funded Matiba and brought him back to Kenya so that Matiba would race against Mwai Kibaki. So Matiba split Mwai Kibaki's votes. The combined total of Matiba and Kibaki would have won the presidency. But then Moi knew this. Moi saw the traction that Mwai Kibaki was amassing as an opposition leader, and he wanted to deal with him. And Ruto sees the traction Gachagua is gaining, and he wants to deal with him. He is going to pull another Kennedy Matiba on him. This guy is wote watasimama na watagawana kura. Tuseme Morara asimame, apewe 1 million votes zake. Kalonzo apewe 2 million. Wetangula asimame, apewe 500. Musalia anaweza kosa kusimama, anakaa kukwama na Ruto. Wasimamishe Gachagua apewe 2 million ama 2.5, zitabaki kura ngapi? Around 5 million, 4 million. Ruto achukue 4 million. Si amechukua hiyo kitu, because akistick na Raila, because mimi nime deal na the millennials and those older than me, and I still see how tribal they are, and I'm assuring you, watu wa Western na watu wa Nyanza, the mood has changed. They now lip-sync Ruto, wanamuona msafi, wanasema Kikuyus voted in Ruto to punish Raila Odinga, and we are going to support their decision. Ruto is our president till 2032. We are going to stick with what Kikuyus chose. You see, it's still tribalism, na sisi hatutaki kuambiwa kitu. 2027 mapema tunapea Ruto kura. Na, you see, those are not empty words. They are going to do it. I mean, they did it with Uhuru. After Uhuru did an handshake with Raila, were they not supporting Uhuru? The biggest defenders of Uhuru hadi wa leo wanakuaga Waluya na Wajaluo. Not even the Kikuyus themselves. Those people telling us how good Uhuru was, and wangalie their last names. And I'm not peddling tribalism. I'm just stating facts here. That we have a tribal country and we follow tribal leaders to their graveyard. Na hapo ndo shida iko. That now the people of Western and Nyanza are comfortable with the government because Raila has done an handshake with the government. They are forgotten. Tulisema Ruto ni mwizi, tukasema Ruto ni mwongo, tukasema ujamaa ni wa story za jaba, tukasema ujamaa kuna mali anatupeleka, tukasema this guy is incompetent, tukasema this guy has initiated another state capture after everything we said. Hata tukasema ujamaa anatupunish na punitive taxes. Wamesahau hizo vitu zote just because their god Raila has done an handshake with Ruto. And that is why I'm warning people against following akina Kasmuel and Morara like gods. Hawa ni watu mnafaa kuwapea time to show their consistency. Unanielewa? Consistency ndio inafanya mtu akubalike. Raila has been consistent for so many years, ndio watu wakuja wamkubali. Ametusaliti at last, but Raila has fought so many battles in this country and won so many of them. Now that he turned out to be a traitor in the end, maybe inaribu legacy yake kidogo hapa na pale, but he has delivered so much for this country. He's delivered multipartism, he's delivered the freedom of expression and media we have today. Yeah, in conjunction with so many people. Hata tukimblame maje, that mzee has tried. Our jamaa, what have they tried to do? Kasmuel has fought for what before this? I have been fighting for 8 years now. I have told you I've done civic education, and I have been informing Kenyans, both on ground and on socials, why we need better governance. I have told you I've been consistent. Mimi ni youth leader from where I come from. I'm the chairperson of youths in my entire ward, and I'm trying to elevate this to the entire county. I would like to have all the youths that were the entire county doing youth empowerment and mentorship, more so empowerment. Let's try to get sponsors, donors, and the government to fund us to do our own projects. Tuache kutegemea wanasiasa. Tuache kungoja election cycle, kupanda jua gari ulipo 500 siku mzima ukikampenia mtu mwenye hata kusahau immediately amepigiwa kura.
So your prediction is, at the end of the day, if things don't change, Ruto will still maintain.
If we are not going to push Ruto to resign, or if we are not going to find an alternative means of removing Ruto from power, including pushing for a motion of impeachment, on Ruto. We should actually storm that parliament again. Our MP wanafaa watuambie why they are comfortable with Ruto as president and they do not want to impeach him. Na tusha point out why we do not want him as president. They are our representatives. They do not represent us when we are saying good things. Mm. I mean, they do not represent us when they are praising the government and we are angry against the government. Mm. Ni kama mimi sahi niende niseme, Andri ameniambia ameshiba hata nini hiyo chakula usiode and Andri is angry akonja vibaya sana sasa wao wanaonyesha we are a picture of us being happy with the current government and we are telling them because sisi ndio watuma we sent our MPs with a message to parliament and to government sisi tumewaambia representation yenye mnatufanyia is unfair sisi tumesema we don't want that president sisi tumesema we want accountability sisi tumesema we want transparency they are not pushing for that hata I think so far mtu mwenye ako consistent ni probably Babu Owino na that senator from Kisii senator Richard Onyonka the rest wako wapi wamewekwa mfuko
so predictions zako ni gani za 2027
Ruto atachukua hii kiti kama hatutampusha resign na atakuwa impeached because kama hii siasa ya ukabila itaendelea because tuna deal na generation yenye koju yetu wazazi wetu na mabrothers wetu wenye hawataki kusikia they are tribal to the core and they do not want to emancipate themselves from tribalism and tribalism will rule us till probably 2042 or 2037 and that is what the problem is if someone does not free themselves from tribalism because let me assure you civic education we will do but it has been done in this country I have been doing it and so many other Kenyans have been doing civic education lakini wa Kenya wako hivi wamefunga masikio hawataki kusikia wanajua kabila ni mbaya tushawaambia tumechoka kuambia hawataki kusikia so if the tribal politics will still reign till 2027. Tell me how you will not win. Ukabila ita rule the day. Wakabila watajigroup na coalition hapo ya wajaluo, waeke waluya hapo, waeke some few people from Mount Kenya wa swing votes, na waeke Rift Valley yote hapo na wakalenjin. How will they not win? Luos have numbers, the Kalenjins have numbers, na Kikuyu wa split some votes. Itabaki sasa hapa ni Wakamba, watu wa Coast, watu wa Wajia na wapi pengine na some swing votes from Central Kenya. If you do the tally tribally, hiyo swing vote imebaki haiwezi win. Ukishikanisha Wakamba, na I am not being pessimistic. If we go by tribal politics, shikanisha Wakamba, watu wa Coast hapo wenye ukua divided juu iko serikali, haiko serikali. Na ujue Raila anasikizwa Coast juu ya ODM unless kukuwe kuna chama ingine 2027. So Coast inaweza enda kwa Ruto. That is wakibaki na Ruto. So itabaki Eastern, Northeastern, Mount Kenya iko divided na uko Turkana. Hao wanaweza pitisha nani? If we go by tribal politics. Because running away from tribalism and freeing a generation and a country from tribalism does not take... I mean, does not take less than, well, I do not want to put a time limit, but I am sure it will take more than 10 years from now.
Mm.
Because we have to phase out the old generation.
Mm.
We have around 8 million votes as Gen Zs. And if we all decide to vote for someone, anaweza pita. Mm. But then we still have Gen Zs who are still tribal. Wanaweza sema hivyo kwa mdomo, oh, tribeless, oh, but they are still tribal. 50% of the Gen Zs want a leader to speak for them, ata Raila Odinga. 50% of the Gen Zs still follow party politics. Oh, mimi nimetoka huku, ichama ndo inaongeaga huku. Awataki kujifree, na lazima ujifree your mind. And if that generation that I belong to that is so liberal, haijajifungua macho, haijajifungua akili, how then about our parents wenye wakujuu yetu? So if tribalism still rules us to 2027, mi sioni tukipitisha mtu hata tusimamishe Gen Z.
Hata Morara ingi.
Ai, hata tukisimamisha Morara na bado tuko na siasa za ukabila. Zitatuharibia kura juu, hata hawa Gen Zs wenye tuko na wao, bado wakona tribalism ndani yao. Unaagi una mtu mwenye anaenda campus, unasikia anaongea ni kama ako class 1. Just because Joe amefanywa CS for mining, na Mbadi amefanywa CS for treasury, na Wandai amefanywa CS for energy, unasikia tu mtu vile anaagi, vile ana reason. We unashindwa tu, where do I start from? Mm-hmm. Morara apigwe 2 million yake strong, na mimi I'm not being pessimistic. Mimi nasema we have to fight battle lingine noma sana hapa kumaliza ukabila. Mimi mwenyewe nilimaliza ukabila by myself. Nilijaribu vile naweza. I rose against that. I convinced myself that a Kisii is as good as I am as a Kamba. That a Kikuyu is as good as a Luo. That a Luo is as good as a Kuria. That a Merian is as good as Msomali mwenye ni Mkenya. So you see the Kenyan Somalis. Mimi I rose against that na nilikubali. And I knew, I figured out by myself that every tribe has its weaknesses. He na he. And every tribe has its strengths. Every tribe has its rich people. Every tribe has its poor people. Hakuna tribe ya watu maskini. Hakuna tribe ya watu wajinga. Hakuna tribe ya watu waasira. Hakuna tribe ya wachawi. Hakuna tribe ya watu wa kiburi, hakuna tribe ya watu wanapenda vita, hizi zote zinakuaga propaganda na story. Peddled by these politicians to divide us tribally. So if we as Gen Zs are not going to rise against tribalism, this is we are going to deliver this seat to whoever will stand. Watu watagawanyishwa kiukabila, sahi wanasema wana ukabila, lakini wewe utaona, si tutakuwa tu hapa. Kuongea ni rahisi lakini kufanya ni ngumu. Sahi plug, tumesema mara ngapi twende streets, we did not achieve what we wanted. We wanted Ruto out of power. Whether by resignation, impeachment, ama by a unanimous vote of no confidence by us. Because sisi kuenda state house, hiyo ni vote of no confidence against the president. I mean, sisi hatujaenda kumsalimia. Unanielewa? Hata hapa office of the president, siko hapa tu Nairobi. Iko hapa tu town. Sisi kuenda kwa office of the president kusema yo, sisi tumekukata. And we form a good chunk of this population, probably 40% or 30%. Na sisi tumekukata. That is a vote of no confidence against the president. And the president should actually be motivated to resign if that happens. But sisi hatutaki. I mean, after finance bill, watu hawaendagi maandamano siku hizi, they think we achieved anything. What did we achieve? After tumeandamana finance bill ikaangushwa. Si wanataka kuirudisha tena. Everybody knows inarudi. After tumeandamana, wakaua so many of us, waka abduct na kukidnap so many of us. What changed? They still appointed people tribally in a bread-based government. What changed? After tumeandamana hiyo yote, the guy is outside there still lying. Si amedanganya there are some German jobs. By the way, on the unemployment issue and the exporting of labor, German stuff, the government should not be so interested in taking Kenyans outside this country. It is not their business. It is the business of government to create a good environment so that businesses thrive here, more investors come here, and that with more investment and businesses booming, we will create employments by ourselves. The private sector is the largest employer in this country. So if you kill the economy, you're killing the private sector. Killing the private sector is killing the employment in this country. And you, when you kill the employment in this country, you leave Kenyans with options of going to other countries to suffer indecent and inhuman treatment. Whatever happens in Saudi Arabia, everyone knows. So the government should not be invested and so interested in taking Kenyans out. Hiyo sio biashara yao. They should be interested in, for example, having bilateral trade agreements that limit child and human trafficking in this country, bilateral trade agreements that assure us that our citizens will be treated decently in Middle East and in those countries they are going to. The government should be invested in representing us in those countries. The government should be interested in setting up laws and policies that govern immigration. That is what the government should be interested in foreign policy. Not in exporting labor. That is not their business. It is their business to create a working economy and a working country so that every Kenyan enjoys staying here, working here, doing business here. And this guy hapo kwa labor ministry, Alfred Mutua, is from Upper Machakos. Mimi, I have little confidence and little trust in Alfred Mutua. I hope he does a better job at the labor ministry, because that ministry has been a strike ministry. Inangojaga strike zifanywe so that they start speaking on how to have a CBA agreement about all these issues. It should be Alfred Mutua who should be advising President Ruto on what to do with the labor issue, on what to do with unemployment. They should be pushing for remote jobs. We should be able to work here without using VPNs and proxies. We should be able to work in our country from the comfort of our homes, in IT companies and in companies that outsource labor. We should not be shipped out to other countries, because that is actually brain drain. Mtu akijipeleka peke yake ni sawa. Lakini the government pushing for brain drain, hiyo mimi sifurahi.
Now, I just want to, for those who want to follow you on social media, how can they get you?
On Facebook, James Mulamba. That's the first account. The second account, James Mulamba Jr. On Twitter, at Wambua James _. On TikTok, James Mulamba Jr. JNR.
All right. Asante, asante.